when you see 10 years as an anniversary, you start to think back to that morning. There was anger, immediate anger, that, you know, you said, how in the world can someone do something that's going to impact the lives like this?
It was almost surreal. I mean, to think that you're watching this actually happen, because they had the video of it and you're watching this, it's almost as if somebody had made this up and done something, you know, with a computer, and because you just didn't ever think it was going to happen here in our country.
Coverage, you know, of what was going on brought it home pretty quick that this is the real deal.
Try and make sure, number one, that it doesn't happen again, but number two, make sure it's not forgotten, and nor any of the people forgotten.
When we got contacted about this event and asking if they could sponsor this and give some of the proceeds to Dan's scholarship fund, we were absolutely thrilled because of what sports meant to him. We were very honored. He was fantastic, and he was little, but his determination was just something you don't see in a lot of people. And he went out there, and you would have thought he was 10 feet tall the way he played.
When he first got to Westfield High School, people were already expecting things from him, and they got them. And one night, after being benched the first quarter by his coach for missing the bus, the coach, about 2 minutes left in the first quarter, came down to him and said, "You ready now?" He said, "I was ready 6 minutes ago." And he came in and threw up 47 with no three-point line. He was a real talent.
So he was All-American in high school, and then, of course, when he went to college, it was a great 4 years with him at Clark, and then ending up going to the NCAA Finals. And then, of course, to find out not long after that Dan got drafted by the Celtics was just like, no way. You know, I thought it was a joke. Like, come on.
The fact that he got drafted in 84 was a source of immense pride, not only for our family, but the community. The Celtics picking a local, you know, Irish guy from Western Mass. He was just our local treasure, you know.
He went over to Ireland and played, and to listen to the people in Ireland talk about him, you would have thought he was God. And then when he came back the year the USBL got started, to see the quality of people that he was playing with, it just made you go like, damn, the Celtics screwed up. They should have kept him.
Look at the guys they play with, Spud Webb, Manute Bol, some really quality players that then ended up in the NBA or what have you, and Danny ended up down on Wall Street, and you know, and kind of the rest is history. The first plane had hit. And I walked by our managing director's office, and I stuck my head, and I said, "Hey, Dale, how's it going?" And he said, "Hey, Maddie, the plane just hit the World Trade Center." I said, "That's not funny, man." I said, "My brother works there." And he said, no, I'm serious, look." And at the time, it had just happened. People didn't know what this thing was. But I was looking to see if there was an antenna on the top or not to figure out which building it was, and realized it was Danny's building. And so immediately went to my office and dialed the phone to his wife, and he had called Kathy. Said that something had happened, the place was filling with smoke, he was going to try to get out, and he'll be in touch. The next morning, Sally and I got in the car and drove up there with these flyers, you know, with the contact information, plastered them all over Ground Zero and all the triage places. And then Cantor Fitzgerald, his company, called a meeting at one of the hotels that night and said, "Look, you know, we got bad news. You know, we're not finding anybody from our company." Well, it was 660 is the number that sticks in my head. We're not coming out with anyone, so you can all probably go home. In Westfield, go walk into the gym, and his jersey is there, and his picture is there, and the winners of the Dan Trant Scholar Athlete Award are there as they enter the gym to play their games. And that's what we have been seeking to do, is just let people remember and know who this guy was as a local legend.
As good a player as he was that good a coach too. It was his passion. As much as sports was, his passion for children and for helping people was just as great. But to listen to the parents of the other kids, "You don't know what your brother did for my child." And they would tell individual stories about, you know, their kid was maybe somebody who got picked on in school or whatever, and Dan just brought them along, and it was like, wow. Like, I don't think we'll ever know how many lives he affected in such a positive way, but it's something that makes me prouder, I think, than to know what an athlete he was.
It's great that we can honor him as a fellow American, a fellow Celtic basketball player. It's great that we can you know, honor and recognize his memory.
Get there. Oh, I like it.
Underhand, see, it's the only way to go.
It's amazing when you think about why we're out here. What happened September 11th. We'll never forget that. You will never forget it. The lesson learned from that is that we have to change hearts. Be good to your neighbor. We all are one. We're one people.
That's a good question. Get up and in!
Oh!
Went to the camera.
Where's the white towel?
We should have fun, enjoy people, enjoy life. And when you get out here with people like we are and trying to do some good things, that's what it's all about.